Hello, everyone, and welcome to Cold Case Files, a Rime of the Frostmaiden actual play stream. Tonight marks our second episode as the party delves deeper into Icewind Dale and its 10 towns. Last time, our party navigated their way with a little bit of help from their Ranger Hawk's guidance and Artificer Edgar's flamethrower to Dugan's Hole, their first stop in the region. Expecting a warm welcome, or at least a warm meal and hot fire, they investigated they surmised was the local tavern, only to find its inhabitants less than welcoming. Sensing a distinct, how should we put it, a close familial tie among the town folk, the party decided to camp on the outskirts of town rather than the charitably offered pile of fishing nets. Before leaving, they did hear tell of the town's trouble. Two missing teenagers left for dead by the speaker of the town, who has refused to give away their precious stores of food in order to retrieve. After a night spent camping in a grouping of trees, they woke to be confronted by a speaking dire wolf who told them his sob story about being beaten by the frost giant master that he held and offered to lead them to his domain where they could rescue the same teenagers that they heard about the day prior. The wolf bounded off, leading them through the snowy terrain, and the party came upon the domain of the Frost Giant. Now, they were promised that the Frost Giant was out. Mina quickly discerned that that's probably not quite accurate with an insight check. And as the party ventured in, they found, well, yes, it was not quite accurate that the Frost Giant was out, but the Frost Giant was dead. Unfortunately, in its wake was the awakened mammoth that was his companion in life. After a bit of ring around the rosy around the room, they managed to defeat the mammoth, explore a bit of the hut, before deciding on taking a long rest. That is where we concluded last week's session. This week, we pick up where we left off, with the party still huddled, waking up after taking a long rest in the Frost Giant's hut. As the party wakes up, and as you will notice from your screen in front of you, they notice that there is a party member missing from their camp. Sorry, I am having a little bit of a technical weirdness. That's why I'm talking. What's going on? Oh, I see what's going on. It's Greg's fault.
What did I do?
Your video was on top of my background. There's this weird bar. We're still learning the technology. So, as I was saying, as the party wakes up, they realize that there are only three where once they quick peer behind the curtain, let you know. Fortunately, Mona Carrie is going to be out this week. Fortunately, that in her area went out about an hour and a half before. So we made the judgment call that we were going to go ahead and play tonight anyways, although we will be down one player. So it just means I have to be a little bit more careful about, you know, killing the party. But yeah, the no party... Well, you don't want a TPK in episode two?
No. I like my character.
So, the party wakes up after a restful sleep. Mona was the last watch of the night. And you find in her stead a simple piece of parchment, folded and left neatly.
What does it say?
I'd like to read the
book. I'm going to read it.
So as you open up the parchment, you see in a very neat, flowing handwriting, and it simply says, "My compatriots, I apologize for not waking you. I have been called on an urgent errand. I shall meet you at the next town up the road. Please, be safe. Mona."
When you said simply says, I thought it was going to just be like BRB. But nope.
So what would the party like to do? I will bring us over to the battle map so that everyone can get awesome. All of the video feeds are gone. We wouldn't, Oh, where'd my other fantasy grounds go? There it is. Cool. That was weird. We wouldn't insult you all with a rehearsed production.
It's all good.
So.
My webcam is a little shrunk there,
yes,
but that's okay.
I will fix that right away.
It's okay.
You're little this week.
That's okay.
Which is weird, considering.
Right, so what would you all like to do?
I don't have any map on mine right now.
If you go ahead and open your character sheet and double click on your token in the top right, it'll open up the map.
Yep. So we had talked about, also, where am I on this map?
You are on the throne.
That's right.
Not a euphemism.
I'm going to take a look outside because there was that extra entrance into this place that we hadn't looked in yet.
Absolutely. So the morning comes, the note is read, and Edgar dashes off down this winding path of stalagmites and stalactites. And as you enter into this other room, there is a huge slatted animal cage, locked gate attached to it by Rusty, standing against the west wall of the chamber. Trapped inside the cage are two shivering humans in cold.
I am so sorry. They told me that they had checked all around the building, and I just realized that we hadn't actually been in here before we went to sleep last night. Let me see if I can get this lock open. And I'm going to take out some alchemist's fire, and right. I'm going to spread it on the frozen lock, hoping that the rapid heating of a very cold object will help shatter the metal or at least weaken it.
Absolutely. Why don't you go ahead and give me a quick arcana check for that?
Sure. Let me find my... Where is my character sheet? I just have... Oh, I can click on myself to pull it up, right? Yes, I can. Love this thing. Arcana.
I mean, I have thieves' tools.
16. So, are you following him into the area?
No.
Okay. So Mina is just kind of sitting back in...
I still don't know there's people in there, so...
It's true. So, Mina, you're still sitting in the main area, and Hawk and Edgar have now dashed off, so you know, you are sitting alone with a frozen cross giant. And Edgar, with a 16, absolutely. So you manage to just, you know exactly how to shape the flames and heat the metal, and hear some bending and warping, and you watch as the hinges kind of break free a little bit, and you might be able to go ahead and work that open.
If I'm headed towards the door, can I hear that?
There hasn't been much sound yet.
Okay. Well, I'm still heading towards the door.
Sure. Yeah, your other compatriots have abandoned you.
I think
I have
some equipment in my bag. I don't know what bag do I have. I always forget. Inventory. Oh, I have a crowbar. Yeah, I'll use my crowbar and my light hammer to try and wrench that door off.
Sure. I'll say because of the heat metal, yeah. So you went ahead and you just put the crowbar in there and you were able to pry the cage open. And as you do so, however, you notice because of all the rust, it does make a horrible scratching noise as it goes, leading Mina to now sprint into the area. You do realize that it's probably a good thing that mammoth was not alive when you made this horrible noise. So the two children that are sitting in there, one of them is a spindly little girl, and as you watch her teeth chatter, you do notice that her teeth have, like, they're semi-pointed. Like, again, not like a bestial type of thing, but definitely more of like a feral look. And the long braids that drape across her shoulders have frost and ice and snow hanging off of them. The other one is a piebald face boy, flanked by small malformed ears. He was looking at the brackets that was holding it together as you came in, and he kind of darted back across the cage. And as he watched you work your craft, his eyes just kind of go wide, and his teeth are chattering like crazy.
When Hawk and Mina enter, I'm just going to look at them and, what? Why did you just let us go to sleep last night? You told me you checked the whole of the place. Why did we were sent here to save children. You said you didn't find them.
We didn't find them where we were searching.
You didn't tell me there was a whole nother room.
You knew there was a whole nother room.
Not that you hadn't checked it.
No, fair. No, I just checked the main area.
They could have been hurt overnight.
But and they were.
What?
We don't know that yet. I get the door open, I'm gonna...
You were here last night?
I'm so sorry. And I'm going to do... Can I check them over to see how hurt they are? How
yeah, absolutely.
Injured?
Go ahead and give me a medicine check.
I will do that.
So you take a quick look over them, and you see that the girl is very cold, and her nose is definitely red, and she seems to be a bit dehydrated, but otherwise she seems to be doing okay. You notice she's like taken off parts of her coat and has wrapped her hands up. Fortunately, the boy, it looks like his hands both have fairly severe frostbite on them at this point.
I'll take off my cloak and pass through the bars to help warm them up.
Well, the gate is open.
They'll have to kind of share one, but... Okay, well...
They'll
have to share it, but...
And they do. They both just take the coat, and because you are much larger than they are being, you know, children, well, teenagers, still, they're able to both kind of huddle underneath the coat together.
I'm 6'4", but I am an elf, so tall, skinny.
Yeah. They are very thin.
Where are my spells?
I'm sorry, say that one more time.
I'm looking for my spells.
I think on your actions, the bottom tab.
Yes, actions. So I'm going to use Healing Word on them. I'm going to mix up some sort of not quite icy hot. like a gentle warming salve that I can put on the boy's hands.
Absolutely.
To bring them slowly up to temperature in a controlled way. And I will do Healing Word on him. That's not how that works. Okay.
That's fine. He doesn't have any hit points.
He doesn't have any hit points? Then I'll use Spare the Dying.
Oh, no, that was my fault. There are tokens on the board. I just didn't put them. And what do you know? They do have hit points. I lied to you on several fronts.
You just keep lying to me.
I apologize to the fine folk over at Fantasy Grounds for assuming that they would not have given me the tokens for these very important figures.
I heal him 5 points of warm damage.
He feels... you can watch as like the color returns to his... or I guess kind of drains away from his face, like the rosiness kind of goes, like he feels warmer, and definitely is more comfortable. And you do notice that while the frostbite is still there, it's receded from like almost up to his palm down to just like his fingertips at this point. So you feel like it did a substantial amount.
Yeah. I can't believe that you were so irresponsible, Hawk.
I gave them my cloak.
Freeze in a cage all night.
Right, it happened. It happened. It's over. We found them. Stop.
We can't go back in the past yet.
No. Are you going to be this careless leading me to East to East Haven?
Would you like to go on your own?
At this point, I'm weighing my options.
Alright, see you later. Oh. I didn't
Stand
think
by,
so.
Please. I need to step away from my computer for just one moment. I apologize.
I was wondering what that beeping noise was.
It was a fire alarm.
Oh, hi, Mo.
That's... We're getting so many signs from the universe that tonight's not happening.
Right?
I didn't think to check this place because I thought that there probably were no kids, at least searching the other 90% of this place. But I did give them the cloak, which, by the way, I'm now down to like just my armor, like all the warm clothing that the Mother Tusk gave us. I gave to the kids.
Well, that's silly.
Live audience.
You won't
doesn't bother me.
You're
out. Sure, let's go with that.
Apologies, the dogs were freaking out.
Your dogs make a very consistent, loud, high-pitched noise.
Well, that's why they were freaking out.
So I'm going to continue checking over the kids while we break camp. And making sure there's nothing like extra.
Absolutely.
Yeah, Rob, for logistical reasons, all the warm clothing that Mother Tusk gave me is now with the kids.
Okay, noted. So you are sans cold weather gear?
Mm-hmm.
Noted.
You're chilly.
All right. So that means I should probably bring up...
So Mother Tusk gave us each... an outfit, right?
Yes, you each got from Mother Tusk a full set of cold weather gear.
Because I bought some for myself as well.
Ah, yes, you did.
So I have that in my bag, so I give it to Hawk.
No, I'm honestly fine. It slows me down, if anything.
All right, fine then. Just shoves
if
it
we
back.
If you find any more prisoners, that might be a good backup in case they need it too.
I'm going to put my gloves over the boy's hands because they might be a slight tight fit for him, but...
Sure.
He's going to lose those if we don't do something.
Accurate, yes. So, yeah, you guys have found the children that you set off to find, and you are still at the Frost Giant's hut. Edgar, you found a very powerful magic chair.
I did, but it doesn't go with the rest of my apartment, so I'm going to have to leave it here. Plus, how would I get through the door?
It's true. So is there anything else you'd like to do here? You're going to start setting back towards the town.
Sorry, that was my street.
You sure?
My dogs are going crazy.
Yeah, so we take them back to the town.
Should we head out? Bring them back to their home?
I think we should prioritize getting these two kids home. I think that's the most important thing that we can do for them at this point.
About how much do they weigh?
They are small teenagers.
Are they like 13 teenagers or 19 teenagers?
No. They're closer to like 13, 14, but they're very scraggly. So I'd say they probably each only weigh 75, 85 pounds at most.
All right.
Somebody in the chat, correct me if I have no idea how small children are. I don't know. If you're under 18, you're all the same.
I mean, I was 5'7" in high school and not the thickest person, so I was like 135, so I have no idea.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'd say like 85 pounds, somewhere in that range.
Well, I'm not carrying them.
Yep.
No one asked you to. They can probably walk.
No, but I was thinking about it.
Yes, they do appear able to walk. They are able to stand up, and they start moving out towards you guys. So are you guys starting to head out?
Yes.
I'll jump ahead and just stay ahead and keep an eye out.
I'm going to leave.
Speaking of.
As you step outside, your friend, the dire wolf, is standing outside. And you notice as you catch sight of him that he is standing quite solidly on this pressure on all four of his. He's got a look in his eye, a snarl on his lips.
You lied to us.
And it almost worked, too. I need everyone to roll initiative.
Dang it.
So happy the Fantasy Grounds had the children roll initiative.
As it should be.
In the thing.
Where is he standing in relation to us?
Right outside.
He is to the south. Well, I mean, you don't know. If you can't see him on your map, then you don't know.
I cannot see him.
Then he is out of your line of sight. He is visible to Hawk.
Yeah.
Oh, he's down there.
Yeah.
All right.
Stop cheating and using the stream to plan. So
I would have had to have been.
I will use every tool at my disposal.
Oh, I should probably have moved the children up.
Yes.
Right.
Oh, they're not staying.
Right back into that cage.
Uh-huh. So, you stay with Edgar.
Mina
doesn't.
I'm going first. And Hawk, you hear from around the corner, your left, growl.
No, that's not favorable.
And another dire wolf charges you, and a howl rips out of his mouth just before he attacks.
Wonderful.
It might. My TV was making the noises because it's connected to my computer and I got confused. All right. So, yes, that is a hit with his first one. So he lashes out and he bites you with 14 points of damage as he latches onto your arm and just kind of rips through your flesh. And I need you to make a strength saving throw.
Okay. Not my strong suit, but that's... That was a 13, but all right.
Yeah, I was going to say, your dice like to get cocked. I'm going to give you the 13. Because that's what 14. I saw on my screen as well.
Yeah, so
that's 14 with the bonus. Manage to stay on your feet as he charges you, and that hurt a little bit.
Yeah,
I'm gonna just say it probably smidge. Hurt a lot.
And Nina, it is your turn.
Okay, so I now have 30 feet of movement, which is very exciting. Instead of 25. So I'm going to come forward to, because I heard that happen.
Yes. Oh, yes. I mean, you didn't even just hear that happen. It was right in front of your face that time.
All right. Do we have another thingy for him?
What?
There's no second wolf token.
What?
There's no second wolf token.
There we go. Oh, there he is.
Hey, look at that.
He's been visible on my screen this whole time.
I don't want to move that far. Just kidding.
He's like, why are you wording it like that?
So I am going to shoot him with my lightning launcher, which is not yet set up.
So go ahead and just roll a ranged attack on that, because it just counts as a ranged weapon.
It's a plus 3.
Sure. Oh, yes, that hits. And so go ahead and roll your 2d6 damage on that. So you guys watch as Mina just kind of like sees the wolf, sees Hawk get gravely injured, and yet still a small smile creeps onto her face. She lifts her palm up towards the wolf and just unleashes this crack of lightning. And deals 8 points of damage to this dire wolf.
Tiny Stark, do 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 do.
And that is now Finn's turn. So one of the children, the boy, is just standing behind you. He's like, I thought you said it was safe. I thought you said it was safe. And just kind of runs shut down up. Into the room.
Free action to yell at him. Tell him to shut up.
Edgar, you're up.
Yes, go back in there. That's probably the safest place for you to be. So the rules for casting multiple spells in the turn, is it they have to be a cantrip or they have to be a bonus action?
So you need to... Your main spell, your non-cantrip spell, needs to be a bonus action, and then you can cast a full action cantrip in addition to.
Okay. Does Hawk look like he's on death's door? Can I do a medicine check to figure out
how
roughly that wolf has severed his arteries on his arm?
Technically bloodied.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you look over easily and you see that his left arm is like, it's still there.
So is he... Hawk, are you in need of, like, immediate attention, or...?
Not immediate, but within a couple rounds, yes.
Should he get bitten again?
Yeah.
I don't have any potions that keep... I don't have any potions of don't get bit. I have... Oh, shit. It was a short rest, so I will do that on my off turn. What my new thing is.
You took a long rest.
Yeah, so...
Okay.
But I get a potion that I create during that time, so I'll do that during not my turn. I'm going to... Can I see the other one? The other wolf. I cannot.
I was gonna say, can you from where you are? No, you can't. But you did. You heard him talk from down there. So, with your intelligence, it would be. I would definitely allow you to know that he's there.
Is it control for the distance between?
Right and left click at the same time.
Okay.
And
I'm going to
do your OCD DM a favor and put yourself on a full square.
I'm actually going to tuck myself into this dark. No, I wouldn't be able to see. I'll tuck myself over here, and I will pull out a little glass vial, like I'll rummage through my bag for a second, grab the correct one, load it into my sling, and swing it and aim for the mouth of Corin. All right. So I need to make a attack. Yes.
Range spell attack?
It is, and it'll be nothing.
So, you guys watch this. You said it was a sling that you were using?
Yes.
Takes out a sling and just goes... Whoo!
Nothing. Oof, into the snow.
Right into the snow.
There's a little, like... of snow.
That's a new sound effect.
Any bonus actions or any other movement that you wanted?
Nope. I'm just going to watch it sail on down.
Fair enough.
Right.
I don't do this often.
I am going to cast Zephyr Strike on myself. That's my bread and butter.
Yep.
Kind of. And back the fuck over here and protect the kid. And take a shot at Cannon.
Sure.
Take a shot at Cannon fodder.
Keenan and Kellen.
Yeah. And this spell gives me advantage. Okay.
That is a hit. Nice, 16 points of damage to him. That did a significant amount of damage to that wolf.
Wonderful.
Any other bonus actions or...
That's it.
All right. So it is now the other wolf's turn. And...
Oh,
you guys are lucky. He's only able to get here. Get to squeeze through his friend there to get through. However, I do need everyone. Not everyone. Mina and Edgar to give me a dexterity saving throw.
I don't like that.
I have failed.
Or that roll.
Dex save.
Dex save, yep.
Dex save.
Ooh.
All right. So.
There's a lot of snow, okay? There's a lot of snow.
Yep. It's at least up to my waist.
You guys watch as this wolf gets there and then stops and breathes in. And as he exhales, a blizzard of snow erupts from his mouth. And you guys take...
Stop these.
Sorry. Oh, that's actually not terrible. These? You guys take 11 points of cold damage as this blizzard just slams into you and freezes your extremity.
What are you saying? That's not terrible.
It was 4d8.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, fair. That's
it is
terrible.
Now the other teenager's turn, and she sprints off around the corner as well.
Sean, take Karen's advice and change the color of the dice.
I like the color of my dice.
I forgot to remove Mona from the initiative order. Apologies. So now it is the other wolf's turn.
Somewhere several towns over, she just thinks,
I should do something.
Do something right now.
And this wolf steps up to you, Mina, and takes a strike at you, and wow, I am... My dice rolls are amazing tonight.
Jeez, man.
It's okay. We have a healer.
Yeah.
Okay.
12 points of piercing damage to you. Eesh. As this wolf steps up and just latches onto you and through your flesh as well.
I'm going to be out real soon.
Mina, it is now your turn.
I'm going to...
Got a potion of healing or something?
I'm back away... over to here. Oh. And I want to check something really quick. So my lightning launcher is not a bonus action, it's an action.
Yep, it is an attack, yep.
All right, well, I'm going to heal myself because I'm down to one.
That seems like a very smart maneuver for you. Any other, anything else?
No, I don't have any bonus actions, really.
Okay. So it is now Finn's turn, and he is going to cower. Edgar.
Fitting.
I'm still trying to figure out what my potion does, because I don't have... Okay, here it is.
It was the bravery one you got, right?
That was last time. It changes every time. That right. one no longer exists. The bravery one is now inert.
Correct. What'd you get this time?
I'm trying to find the table it shows up on.
Sure.
Okay, so I need to roll a d6.
Do we?
A three.
Resilience. Drinker gains a +1 bonus to AC for 10 minutes.
That's not bad.
I'm going to pop that sucker. that's a free action, right?
No, so drinking potions does, technically by rules as written, take a full action.
I thought drinking a potion was a bonus action. Giving it to someone else is a full action.
That is healing.
Yeah, I thought that's what we decided last time.
So that is healing potions. I'm looking up to be certain.
Okay. Then I am not going to do that.
Okay, hold 1 second. It is a full action, according to Jeremy Crawford, and he is very adamant about that point.
Okay.
All right, then. What I'm going to do is... Hawk, you're not doing too good, right?
Half.
He's
felt withdrawing better, he's felt worse.
Is withdrawing an action?
Disengage?
Disengage, yeah.
Yes, you can use an action to disengage.
Then I'm going to disengage and then move my 25 over here. And as I run, I'm going to spend my last spell slot slinging a healing word potion right at the back of Hawk's, back.
So you watch Hawk out of the corner of your eye as Edgar just books it. And then all of a sudden you just feel smack in the back of your head. And you take 5 points of healing.
Oh, thanks.
And I can give that to you.
Oh, right. I should drop it directly on him.
That's fine. I can also, I found out that I can drop it from chat onto people.
Perfect.
That's all right. Nice.
Hawk, it is now your turn.
All right. Oh, Cannon and Corrin. Okay.
Yeah, it's like the Mina and Mona, except of the Dire Wolf world.
Yeah.
Conan.
Okay. I'm gonna draw my bow.
Oh, I can't see him anymore. That's right.
And take a shot at Cannon. And have it phase into if herself is watching a frying pan.
She is.
Yeah.
So Hawk, she was singing Hawk earlier. Draws the bow back and launches it, and the arrow just kind of disappears as soon as it leaves the bow and
it hits.
Rematerializes right before Kanan's face as a frying pan and slams into him, actually shaking his. Deals 10 points of force damage to him. This wolf is severely.
Go back here.
That's so close to me.
And Corrin fails to recharge his cold breath, just so you guys have that peace of mind.
Oh, good.
And he does. You take his movement to charge you. He's going to charge it, Edgar.
That's unfair.
Take a bite at Edgar. And hits. Wait, did you drink? Sure? No, you did not end up drinking that potion.
I did not drink that potion.
Would that have helped?
I don't think so.
All right. And deals 13 points of damage to you, dropping Edgar to the snow. And Silja, the young girl, just kind of went behind the corner. Now it is the And he's going to step up and just kind of guard his friend's back because he can't get at you guys. Mina, you're up.
Growl intensely.
All right.
I'm going to move him here so he's effectively blocking the path.
Got anything to bring him back up? Great.
I am going to cast... I'm going to use my lightning launcher again.
All right.
That hits again.
Very nice.
And then... Did it go into the thing?
It did not.
No, it did not.
I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt that it actually hit. Go ahead and roll the damage on it. I trust you. Go ahead and roll your damage right on that wolf. 2d6. Oh, that's right. You can't roll it on the wolf because you don't have it set up as weapon yet.
Not yet, no.
That's fine. So 4 points. And that was
I can help you with that during the break.
That was on the leaning one? Leading one?
No, that was on the bottom one.
The more, all right, the more
Kanan.
Devastatingly injured one. And I believe it was a Tiny Stark, as we were calling you beforehand.
Yes.
reaches out her palm and lightning arcs through the air again, and you just watch as the fur sizzles and the slumps.
Tiny Stark,
doo 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 doo. No.
What?
I will bring it back to life.
Edgar. Take it off.
Let's see how much I died.
So that is a success. From here on out, what I am going to say is what I would like you guys to do is use the dice tower to roll all death saving throws from here on out so that your party has no idea how close you are to death.
Okay.
Adds a little bit of suspense to the process, but...
Oh, good.
Hawk, you're up.
Great.
You can thank my friend Scott Kegler for that idea.
Scott
is the...
Curse you, Scott!
No, that's right, all three of you know Scott. Yeah. From very different reasons.
I'm going to... take out my scimitar and smack a wolf with a frying pan.
You guys clearly see a scimitar come out of the sheath, and as Hawk swings, it transforms again into a frying pan and just smacks this thing right upside the face. Deals
to be fair, I don't see jack shit.
You don't see anything.
I see God.
Tell him to heal.
And Corin does recharge Hold Breath. Oh, but goody. He's not going to use it because you're all just right there. So he's just going to take a nibble at Hawk. Just a little nip. Just a big nibble.
That's not good. That should be... fine.
You're still up. So,
yeah.
Enraged at the dropping of his brother, he just lunges at you. And he grabs you with his paws and rips into your shoulder, with bringing you within an inch of the darkness. Kanan is longer.
To be fair, I was closer. Mina. I was closer.
Yeah, it's true. Technically, you are.
That much damage would have dropped Edgar in one go.
Yeah.
Mina, you are up.
All right. How is he looking?
He is looking okay because this is the first amount of damage was dealt to him, but he's... he doesn't look like he has much vitality. That helps.
Hmm. All right. A medicine check would be an action, right?
It depends on what you're trying to do. Are you trying to just suss out how many hit points, how he's doing, or are you trying to actually do something, unless you try to stabilize him?
I was just trying to stabilize Edgar.
And then it would be an action, yes.
Okay. I'd rather get rid of this thing as soon as I can before I start trying to bring people back to life. So I am going to Tiny Stark it again.
All right. There you go. That is a hit.
That one actually went into the chat.
It did, yes.
Yes!
10 points of damage. This other wolf is looking severely crispy at the moment. Still up, but not loving it. And cowers. Edgar, using the dice tower, please give me saving throw. Noted. Hawk, you are up.
I mean, it's taking damage. I've taken damage.
I'm the most healthy, so.
I'm gonna cast Zephyr Strike on myself again.
Yes.
All right.
And jump back just a little bit.
Sure.
And take a shot with advantage.
That's a hit.
That advantage was very helpful to you. That is a hit.
Yes, indeed.
Kill it.
So kill it. As you jump out of the way, it actually starts to swing at you, but you manage to dodge out of the way just in time. And your arrow launches, transforms.
This one's going to be a broken bottle.
So it transforms into a wine bottle that you watch as, like, the front of it deteriorates away, leaving just jagged edges that slam into the chest of this wolf, and it just coughs up a bit of blood and then slumps to the ground dead.
Yes.
Duh.
You have two corpses of dire wolves at your feet.
All right, so I'm going to do at least a medicine check right now. On Edgar, see if we can at least stabilize him.
Yep, absolutely.
I'm gonna recover my arrows. There we go.
Nope. All right.
You're not able to bind the wound well enough. Edgar, can I get one more death saving throw, please?
Please don't be dead.
And you watch as the, your efforts actually seem to cause him a little bit more harm, and a little bit more blood gushes out. However, I will say that because you have unlimited time at this point, you are able to work on him a little bit more.
Is there unlimited time? Because I've got more death saves to go through. I don't know if there's unlimited time.
I'm going to.
Yes, can I look in his pouch and see if I can find any, like, healing potions or anything?
I'm just going to cast Cure Wounds on him.
Yeah.
Or that. That was works
the
other too. Thing.
We have Cure Wounds and the fact that I know how your death saves are lying right now. So you have at least 12 seconds left, which is two additional actions. So I'm going to say that, yes, in that amount of time, she could at least stabilize you and then Cure Wound on you. So, Edgar, you gasp back into life. And you look over, and your arm's a bit mangled, but it's no longer bleeding.
Oh, you're right, Edgar.
No.
Oh. No.
Well, he's not unconscious anymore.
I'm really not all right. And I'm going to go through my pouch and find something that I can heat up.
Okay.
Relatively quickly. And try to, like,
cauterize
and also something wooden to put in my mouth and, like, burn a little bit.
Yeah. So you guys
while we're here,
you guys watch as, like, Edgar just finds like a stick on the ground, puts it in his mouth, takes out like his spoon for his dinner. It turns red hot and he just presses it against his wound.
Ow. All right, with that, I'm gonna just do a little healing on Hawk.
Thank you.
I'm gonna realize that I can't get the spoon hot enough to actually cauterize wounds, and then I'm gonna actually look for my medicine kit and do proper medicine on myself.
I mean, at least it sizzles a little bit, but like, yeah, not much. If you guys would like to take a short rest, you can go ahead and cover some hit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can I use my medicine kit to heal a little bit more? I don't know if that's a feat or if that's something new with medicine kit.
That is a feat that can be done. That is not just a natural thing. That is a feat.
The healer feat?
Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, I don't have a healer's kit in my back.
Well, then you definitely can't do it.
Or did I put it in under surgeon's tools? Nope, that's leather working. What am I looking for?
I don't know.
Okay.
I could do a tinker check and see if I can make something to help you.
That's okay. I'll just reroll hit dice. I've got them. -1
That's really sad, dude.
Wow.
Does explain why you have
no hit points.
16 hit points.
Yeah, you might want
to. Like, I have almost double your hit points.
I'm a sickly Victorian child. Leave me alone.
I was just about to remind our stream that you can look at our player stats, but for some reason, that extension doesn't seem to want to be working right now. So I'll fix that during our break. So, after that harrowing battle that just took place, and coming near death, all of you...
Thank you, Karen.
You went ahead and were able to bring the children back to the town, if that's what you...
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
I want to get out of here.
Yes, out of here would be good.
So you're no longer a fan of Dugan's Hole?
No, we're just we.
No, I want to get back to Dugan's Hole. I want to get back to the safety of Dugan's Hole.
Safety might be pushing it.
So compared to this, Dugan's Hole is very safe.
So it takes you about 4 hours of trudging through the snow with these to get back to Dugan's Hole, but you are able to make it back with very little. At one point, you do hear the wind start to pick up, and you're afraid for a moment a blizzard's going to kick through, but it seems to blow around you, your luck seeming to hold for once in this campaign. And as you make it back to the town, which... I will reshare the map with you all. You see the beauty that is Dugan's Hole.
I have to keep up my D&D Beyond, all my abilities, because I keep forgetting the specifics of the ranger.
Yes, it is a new class, so I get that.
It's not so much a new class, it's just it's so specific about the wording and everything.
Oh, I was just informed that I keep like that. Cutting out. I think the reason is I turned up the noise gate so high because my mouse was clicking and getting picked up, so let me fix that again. All right, so...
Who's playing music?
It was probably my TV in the background.
Oh, okay.
That's why I had the noise gate up as well. So, it is what it is. Okay. So... You make it back to Dugan's Hole, coming in from the westward point of the city, and it is mid-afternoon at this point, which is one of the only times that you actually have some light. It looks like early evening at this point. And you happen to catch there are a few people moving between the houses, but I'm talking like two and three. And they all have the same very slender build that you're starting to get used to in this area. And so you were informed where the speaker's house was last time. That's this building right here.
Yeah.
I don't know why I pointed to it. There's a large black arrow that points to it, calling it the speaker's house as well. But, you know, so...
we appreciate your assistance in case we couldn't read that.
And then there was also the building that you assumed was a tavern that turned out to be very much not a tavern.
Is that where we're bringing the kids back to, though?
I don't know.
On the way, we can ask the kids, where do you live? Where in Dugan's Hole?
Well, I talk to them. Taking you?
Yeah.
So you start talking to the children on the way back.
Yes. All right, you beasts. Where do you live?
So there it is. That's the one I'm looking for. So the girl looks. She's like, my mother's name is Hilda. She lives on the eastern edge of town.
All right, could you lead us to her?
Oh, absolutely, yeah, yes, of course.
So you guys get back to the town, and the little girl who I hope by this point you've asked her name.
Well, we know it's Syl.
So her name is Silja, or Silja. And his name is Finn.
Yeah, we got that part.
Yeah, Syl and Finn. Two missing kids taken by wolves.
Right.
Oh, I keep forgetting to ask you this, but during that short rest where we were trying to not die anymore, the boots that with the gems on them.
Yes.
I want to spend some time identifying them.
Sure. Let me find those for you. I don't remember where those were. Oh, did I actually put them in your inventory?
No idea. Nope.
No, why would I have done that? That would have been smart. Hey, there they are. I put them in the party sheet. So, you took the short rest, and you found out that these are Boots of False Tracks.
Okay.
The soles of these boots are covered in runes. While wearing the boots, you can choose to have them leave tracks like those of any other type of humanoid of your size. So for you, that's like kobolds and goblins.
Gnomes.
Well, he is a gnome.
I'm a halfling.
He's a halfling. Oh, so you are still small size, right?
Wow, way to just do a microaggression at me, Rob.
Sorry. Karen can attest I do the same thing in the other game.
We can attest too. Oh,
just yeah, because true. We call you Tall Rob doesn't mean you're to talk about this.
Right. So, yes, you have those boots, and you are informed that they live in this little house right here.
I thought you were still talking about the boots.
No, the children.
Are they in the small
that
one?
That is the smallest house in town.
It is, yes.
Aw.
Well, there's a couple of sheds.
I don't feel bad for them.
Yeah, they're like garages, but...
So you guys bring them back to this house.
They're fancy Porsches.
I mean, none of these houses are well-maintained. Most of them are falling apart in some way, shape, or form. You notice that the snow in the streets, it's got footprints through it, like people have moved through, but it's not what you would expect to be a town. Like, there's no, like, well-worn paths, and there hasn't been much snow lately, so you know that there's just not much travel going out in this about in this town. But you manage to get back to the house, and they immediately just throw open the door, and they run in. Mom! 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 And, this... older woman, middle-aged, you think, but hair is very stringy and gray. Definitely bags under her eyes, and her eyes just light up when she sees her children, though. And she just looks at you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. You saved my children. My husband would be so happy.
Oh. She's just hugging the children.
I am not in the house, by the way. I am.
Did anyone go into the house, or did you let the children run in and you're staying outside?
I would have followed them in.
Sure. I'm standing outside next to Hawk.
Absolutely.
They sustained some injuries from the cold. It would be a good idea to have them see a local healer. And if you have anyone practiced in medicine, I would also like to see them. If that is not too much trouble. Is there a doctor in town? Is there?
No, we don't have any doctors here. We send ours to send our ill to East Haven to be cured.
Well, you should do that. Finn has some frostbite on his hands. And...
Oh, he'll be fine. No one in Duke and Tall isn't without a little bit of frostbite. I've only got 8 toes.
He'll have almost no fingers if you don't send him. He'll actually have no fingers if you don't send him.
Oh,
you should
that
do
is
that.
Very, well, thank you. I don't have much. Oh, one moment.
And she runs towards the back, and she opens up a chest, and she takes out a pair of boots and walks towards you.
My husband was a bit of a drinker, really. And in a drinking contest, he won these off of an adventurer, and they're yours for bringing my children back.
And hands you a pair of boots.
I have to ask, are boots a currency in the Ten Towns? I know that sounds strange, but I know people trade with all sorts of weird things, and you are not the first person to give me boots here.
No, we tend to use gold and silver, and I mean, sometimes fish, and, good mead uses their mead, of course.
Okay, that's fine. I'll take the boots. Thank you. Is there anyone in town, anywhere in town we can buy provisions or restock our supplies?
Unfortunately, no. This town doesn't really have a store of any sort.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
And she just it gives you a big grin, and you notice that her teeth are also that same sort of like pointy teeth, but she's missing a few of them at this point.
Are you... Odd questions. I have many because I am from outside of this part of the world. Do you happen to be related to anyone in town besides children?
Yeah, most of them.
Through marriage or...
Oh, my late...
Birth?
My late husband was... Well, we grew up together. We grew up together. Our parents raised us right. They did, and so we kept the family line going. Most of us here in town do the same.
Excellent. Well, thank you for the boots, and I... We'll be headed to East Haven to see a doctor. I hope that you do the same with your son, Finn. Maybe consider getting out of town a little bit. See other places.
Now, Duke and Tom's always treated us fine. Thank you, though. Thank you.
Sure. And I'm going to rejoin the party.
So it is.
How'd it go?
Good.
She gave me more boots. What do these boots look like? Are they just boots?
They are not just boots. Let me bring up the description of them. I already put them in your inventory, just so you know.
Ooh.
So they are fine. They look very fine. And they have the softest furs. lining the inside of the knee-length boots. They look very comfortable and warm.
Can I do... I would have to spend some time then to change that.
Well, we're in town, so we can rest up before we head out and hopefully find Mina or Mona. One of you two.
Mona is awaiting us at East Haven.
Oh, right.
Or Goodmead, whatever the next town is.
I think it's Goodmead and then on to East Haven.
I can check the map.
If we're going to spend some time in town before we leave, I am curious about... I mean, somebody should talk some sense into the speaker, but I mean, we might be able to talk to somebody in the next town about having them talk to whoever runs this town. It seems poorly managed if they're... but I'd like to visit the 20 Stones of Three.
Edgar.
Yes.
Their town. Their monkeys. They have been to here. We have not. Leave them alone. We're not going to live here.
A strongly worded letter when we get to Goodmead. And I'll place it in the hands of that town leader or alderman or whoever. But before we leave, I would like to check out the 20th.
Ooh.
Yes, is that they've already known. And they've
I just noticed the boots, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Who wants the boots of false tracks? I will tell you that's what they are. They're sparkly. They leave.
They are false garish. Tracks. Like,
they are
bedazzled.
They do not match my sensibilities in the least. And they. I have no use for leaving false tracks. No one's following me, as far as I know. And if they're following me, they're probably walking faster than me. Someone else can have them.
All right, I'll take them.
Perfect.
That works. And you're taking the other boots that you were just handed?
Yeah. If I have some time, I'll inspect them. Hawk, did you recover your cold weather gear from the children before we sent them running into their parents?
Meh.
You say, we're in a blizzard.
Yes. And?
Fuck it, fine. I'm going to
you notice, like, where my skin would usually be, like, probably blue or starting to, like, show signs of, like, light frostbite. It's perfectly fine.
When we get to East Haven, we are sitting down and having a drink, and I'm asking you a long backlog of questions.
All right, and I have a short list of answers.
And on that note, it is 9:21, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to take our break. We will be back in 15 minutes. I am going to say now, we're going to start doing this every week. I own a small miniatures business called McPherson Minis. And I'm going to be offering through that business a miniature each session as a prize for those of you who join us during these streams. So
they are so well done.
That thank you. I will just ask that you please, if you are watching us on another channel than McPherson's Lair, please head over to McPherson's Lair to do this, and just into your chat. Just type in the keyword for tonight, which will be frying pan. And this is what you will be able to win tonight. It is Oriel the Frost Maiden, a dice holder. So you'll be able to... Oh, I have a dice here somewhere.
Is that your paint job?
This is my paint job, yes.
Damn, dude.
Just did this
getting better and better.
Thank you very much. So Oriel will be on display, and I will actually put a picture of her that does better justice than this webcam can do up during the break. So go ahead and type that into chat, and I will go ahead and randomly select someone at the end of that. And just also note that if you go onto our Facebook page, Cold Case at Cold Case Files on Facebook, you can find a link to another contest we're running to celebrate the release of Tasha's Cauldron of Everything and the launch of our stream. I'm going to go ahead and offer a free copy of the book to somebody. All you have to do is follow the link on there. It'll require you following on Twitch, visiting a couple of things to do the entries. It's one of those type of contests. But go ahead and follow there, and next Thursday when it comes out, we'll select a winner there, and we'll get that mailed out to you. If we reach 50 followers before then, also, we're going to upgrade that to the special edition cover, which I am addicted to. Ooh. Thank you, Wizards of the Coast, for taking even more money out of my wallet. Love you. All right, we're going to go ahead and go on break now. We will be back at approximately 9:40 to finish up tonight's session. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in just a little bit. Just a reminder, we are giving away that dice holder that you're seeing on this break screen, so just go ahead and type into the chat frying pan, and that's going to give you an entry into the random contest. And it looks like we have few enough people in the chat and who will be participating that I'm going to roll an actual dice to figure out who gets it. We'll be back soon. Edgar apparently was unclear about the situation, but I believe that Mina has filled him in thoroughly at this point. And if I'm not mistaken, the last we saw of Edgar, he was walking down the street going, la 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 la. So, it looks like we have four entrants into the contest today. If somebody has a large... Is anyone else... Because my chat refreshed, so I just want to be 100% positive. So I'm going to give you, let's call it 30 more seconds. If you are in chat right now and you are interested in winning the Oriel Dice Holder from Dice Heads and McPherson Minis, go ahead and type frying pan into the chat. I'll give you 30 seconds to do that just in case you missed it. Right now, just so you know, I have Jay DiCarlo 26, Vader's Valkyrie, Aaron KH 26, and C Googliotti as entrants. So if I did not just list off your
I'm going to jump in and say, don't put me into the.
Okay.
I think I was I typed it out just in case people needed.
Got it. Or didn't hear it. So if nobody else would like to enter into that contest today, yep, I got yours, Chris, just so you know. And hey, luckily I'm doing this by hand, so you didn't just disqualify yourself, because apparently that's a thing with Twitch contests. I don't know. I'm just going off. I don't know. all right. So.
They also have like 10 mods and a chat that is constantly moving.
It's true. Someday we'll have 146,000 viewers.
Jesus. I remember when it was like when they hit their first 500.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. I wasn't even aware of them at that point. All right. So here we go. So for Oriel from Dice Heads and McPherson Minis. Here we go. So I'm going to roll this nice D4, which is also from the Rhyme of the Frost Maiden kit, because, oh, my God, did Wizards get so much money out of me for this campaign. So here we go. It's going to be, for Vader's Valkyrie, is going to be a 1. Aaron, you're going to be a 2. And Chris, you're going to be a 3. And on 4, I'm going to re-roll it. So here we go. And that, I was going to move my webcam down so you guys could see it, but it took me like 15 minutes to get it right. Set back up quickly. So that's going to be a 2. So that is going to Aaron K. Sorry, the screen's on my other screen right now. So Aaron KH 26. So go ahead and is private messaging a thing on Twitch?
I don't know.
Rob, it's Aaron from She Kills Monsters.
Oh, awesome. I have your information. Cool. Cool. Then I will be in touch and I will get this sent out to you ASAP. All right. I was wondering if it was or not, but I couldn't tell because, you know, usernames. All right. So with that, we are back to Dugan's Hole and the cold, windy day that our adventurers are surrounded by as they make their way through the town after delivering the children safely. What would you all like to do at this point?
Well, I'm guessing that we took our long rest, or we took a long rest, and if we did, we took it like back where our campsite was.
So, okay, so there's nothing else you want to do throughout the day before you head back for a long rest then?
I would like to check out the 20 stones of Thrun.
Sure. I would like, well.
All right. So you guys make your way through the town. Again, it's pretty much deserted, so you don't bump into anyone as you make your way through the town. But you make it out to the southwest, and you once again just see this ring of megaliths standing in front of you. Now that you see it more in the light of day, as much as there is light of day, you do see that it is formed into somewhat of a triangle with 19 stones surrounding a single stone in the center.
Are there any carvings on these, or?
Give me an investigation.
Well,
that shouldn't be too bad. It's intelligence based, isn't it?
Oh, right. Yeah. Investigation, I'm good at.
Yeah, it's perception that you're awful at.
I can look at these stones all I want, but if someone tries to sneak up on me, I'm not going to know what's happening.
What do you mean sneak up on you? If somebody walks right up to your face, you're not so good at it.
That's called sneaking up on me. If they don't give me 2 to 3 business days notice, it's sneaking up on me.
So with an 11 being the stronger of the two, you go ahead and you take a look around, spending 10-15 minutes looking around each stone. Actually, it probably takes you a good 45 minutes to look at each of the stones carefully. And no, you don't notice any real carvings on these.
Interesting. Is there... So I can see the night sky.
It's starting to get dark enough now that yes.
Can I do like a nature check to see if they line up with the stars in any way that seems relevant, or
sure,
if there's anything along those lines that might do absolutely something? 11 again.
11 again. You're really liking those 11s. Just give me 1 second to
11.
Something up real quick. Do 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 do.
For some reason, I feel like this is the equivalent of like one of those puzzles where it's you put a circle in the circle, a triangle, and then the square block in the square hole. And I'm just like, I've got a protractor, I've got a compass, I've got like a level, and I'm just checking everything out. And it's like,
Yeah, so you do. You spend a good half hour, 45 minutes, again, just like, as you said, you have your tools out, you're taking measurements, you're jotting things down, you're looking at the stars and making notations. And after this amount of time, just nothing seems to line up. It just doesn't seem to make sense.
Okay, maybe I'd like to see if there seems to be any magic. Not like I can't detect magic being there, but I want to see if the alignment seems to have any sort of magic significance, because I've studied.
Sure, that'd be an arcana check.
Yeah, so like similar to my current work of making the mundane mimic the magic, I want to see if they're. Oh, a 13. We've broken the 13s.
We've broken the 11s. So yeah, you take a look and. I mean, there's definitely some runes that you've worked with that have triangular bases to them, but you can't seem to relate that to the 19 or the 20 number, you know, the 19 surrounding or the 20 with counting the one in the center. It doesn't seem to ring any bells.
All right. Well, I guess the last thing to do is use my wand of secrets, and I will use my wand of secrets. Sure. And I'll see if I can get any trapdoors, secret doors, hidden entrances in this stone ring. Try absolutely to use the
so the vibration. So you guys watch as Edgar takes out this. It's a wand, but it's also, as you saw in the stream, a tuning fork. And just walk up to, like, I assume the center stone, probably, due to its significance, and tap it against it. And you guys do hear as, like, this echo of the tuning fork kind of bounces around the circle a bit in this arcane manner. And Edgar's eyes just kind of gloss over this glossy white as he attunes to the secrets of the world around him. Edgar, your vision just starts to like dart out from your body and swim around, and like where you were examining the stones before, you're now almost seeing them at the molecular level through this. And it all happens in a blink of an eye, but to you it's like hours of just scouring these stones, and just nothing seems to stand out.
It's just rocks. They just put up rocks because it looks nice. That's all there is. Just like everything in this town, it's just here because nobody bothered to move it.
If that is not the best description of Dugan's Hole, I don't know what is.
I am thoroughly disappointed in this one wonder in this wonderless town.
So, are you ready to leave?
Yes. Wonderful. I would very much like to put a lot of distance between me and these 20
Mina has fallen.
Infernal stones.
So you guys gonna go ahead and make camp for the night?
Yes, but nowhere near the stones.
Please wake up, Mina.
So the two of them start to walk away, and just the crunching of the snow by your sleeping form, just like you startle back to wakefulness.
Oh, we're done.
Yes, we're done. It's nothing.
Well, it's about time. Look, it's dark out.
it is in fact dark out, and you guys make your way back towards that same copse of trees, where you set up camp again for the evening. Who's going to take first watch?
I'll take first watch.
All right. Hawk, roll me a perception check.
Is it a...
Wouldn't it make more sense for Hawk to take the middle watch, since he doesn't have to be asleep for as long?
I do 4 hours of a semi-conscious trance, so... Whatever watch, it doesn't really matter.
All right.
Easiest to take the first one.
Yeah, the two of us could stay awake for 2 hours apiece, and then he can cover the rest of the night.
Yeah.
It gives everyone a long rest. Gives everybody a long rest.
Yeah, so I'll take the first two watches. Sure. If it's splitting up to four, then I'll take the first two.
Okay. So you guys go ahead. So just give me, Hawk, I got your perception. Yep. 14. Who's going to take the next set of watches?
I'll take the... Okay.
Oh, I'm going to take pleasure in waking you up, dear.
So... Mina, you go ahead and you take the second watch. Go ahead and give me your perception check, please.
Helps if I'm on the right screen.
So your watch is boring as hell. And you wake up right before the end of your watch. Not realizing that you seem to have dozed off for a minute. And you do see that there are definitely large footprints right around the side of your camp.
Oh boy.
But nothing seems to have disturbed you.
What kind of footprints?
They look bear-like.
Okay. So I'm going to shake Edgar awake and say, watch out, there was a bear, and lay down and go back to sleep.
And you, did you do anything about it? What kind of bear, how long ago?
She's asleep.
And I'm going to take my watch.
All right. Go ahead and give me a perception check.
Oh no!
Oh, no. A zero!
Oh no! Change the color on your dice too!
No, I'm sticking with these.
This is the first zero of our campaign. I have a feeling it will not be our last.
Yeah.
Do you know how many minus ones I have? I'll give you a hint. The answer is not one.
All right, let me check something. You got extremely lucky.
Oh, good.
Did I?
You did, yes. So you're like, there's a bear, and you kind of like curl up into your blanket, kind of like hiding a little bit, and you wake up in the morning. luckily, there does not seem to be any fresh footprints, So it looks like the third watch went by uneventful. However, you are all three awake now. The dawn has just started, as it were.
I got way to Goodmead.
All right, so you guys are headed out without stopping back by your favorite town?
Yes. Yes, we're out.
I am going to put on the boots of the Winterlands because I think while huddled in my blanket, I would have prepped some new spells or new potions, and I got the AC potion again, and I would have figured out what the boots do.
Yes, you did figure out what it did, and I believe, I'm just checking, yes, I have already unmasked it in your inventory, so you know what those do.
Are you going to long rest us?
I suppose I can do that. Oh, nope, that's wrong initiative. Question, sorry, Rob. Wrong button.
Question, Rob.
Yes.
Are you taking the alternate spell thing that I messaged you about a few days ago into account now or until the book comes out?
Let's wait until the book comes out officially.
Okay.
Looking
forward to that.
Although, actually, you know what? No, because I am I'm allowing Sean with Mina to use Unearthed Arcana stuff, so go ahead. You can use it as of now. Cool.
Luckily, I won't be UA for much longer.
Yeah. Well, same with his spell thing that we were just talking about. So
Yeah.
That'll be next Thursday. And just a really quick plug there. Just remember, you can visit our Facebook page and join the contest to win a copy of Tasha's Cauldron of Everything. Sorry, I blanked on that for a second. Awesome.
Just a reminder, guys, we only get back half of our hit dice after a long rest.
Rounded up.
Correct. Is it rounded
up? Rounded
is it
down.
Rounded up?
Because mine just rounded
in the
down.
Book it's rounded up, but I guess I didn't do it, so
Weird. I've D&D.
It's one of the only things down. Rounded up. And anything healing is rounded up.
Ah, gotcha. Alright. So you guys go ahead and you set off. Now the town that you are currently in is as you can see on the map. I can show to our players, or our viewers, and possibly our players. Trying to figure out what it's called in here. Here we go. I'm just going to share this with everyone again so it pops up. Sorry to those who are viewing it. Need to just resize things real quick. So you guys are here in Dugan's Hole. The days of you chuckling over that are coming to an end, and you are making your way over to Goodmead, which is the next town up the road. And as you leave town, you're all used to, you know, roads in this world. Faerun is a fairly civilized world. And what you find is more of a road. it's a fairly well-worn path. But it is it's very narrow. Like, you imagine that like a single horse cart could get through at any time, and it's fairly snowed over. As if people do not make this travel very often.
So for marching order, I'm just going to say Hawk's in the front. I'll be in the back so that I can pick up Edgar anytime he like falls into deeper snow.
You don't need to anymore because I got those boots of the Winterlands on.
So, so Mina, you're like standing with your hand like poised over Edgar. And he's just kind of like trotting along. In fact, he's walking faster than you are.
Hey, I have snowshoes on.
Oh, that's right. You do have snowshoes on. So
you guys are also with me.
But these boots were made for walking.
Yeah, it's true. His boots were made for walking through hellish snow conditions.
Fair enough.
Like, literally.
That makes me happy.
So, yeah, so you guys set off at about, I mean, again, it's really hard to tell time exactly, but you know that the light has just started to come up, and you know that light in these areas tend to last for approximately 4 hours. And so you start walking, so you make it after 4 hours, because the light is just starting to die, you do make it to the town of Goodmead. And
is that a misnomer?
Say again?
Is that a misnomer? Or is there actually Goodmead here?
You'll find out.
There's a mead hall.
So as you approach the town from the west, you see already that this town is more well kept than Dugan's Hole. It is definitely cleaner. The roads look like they have been traversed on a fairly regular basis.
The gene pool's a little bit wider.
Well, you haven't seen any people yet, but I mean, that's a fairly safe assumption there. So yeah, you go ahead and you make your way into the town.
Alrighty. What are these speakers?
So
Dolby surround sound.
I was fully expecting.
Give me a history check. Let's see if you know that.
All right. Nope.
An 11? So, no, you don't know exactly what they are, but by the way that people were talking about them, you gather that they are probably akin to, like, a mayor. Something
all
like
right.
That. That's your best guess.
All right.
So what is your goal as you head into Goodmead?
Finding out if there's actually Goodmead.
So you're going to seek out a mead hall?
Yes.
All right, go ahead and give me a quick investigation. Yes, I know that you can see it on your map.
Yeah, but Mina's not looking at the same map. Hell yeah.
Yeah, so you guys take about 5-10 minutes, and actually you meet up with a female dwarf who's walking through the streets, and you ask her, where can I get some meat? And she just smiles broadly, and she gestures, and she's like, oh, that's right down the road there. You can head to the east. If you've got to the docks, you got too far then. So just take a left right before the docks, and you'll see it. You can't miss it. It's a large building. Pride of the town it is. Pride of the town. Yep.
You've been there recently then.
I don't know why you would say that.
Thanks for your help.
You're welcome. Have a lovely day. Oh, she was a nice one.
Before you leave. Is there a provisions store? Is there a market or a
general store?
A general store or perhaps a doctor?
We don't have a general store per se, but the mead hall does have some general supplies, some basic supplies. Not much though.
Where do you people buy your things?
From East Haven, mostly.
Great.
Every once in a while, we get a traveling market coming through. That would be a Torg's market. Comes through every now and again.
So, if someone were to set up, say, a trading post in this town, that would go over well, you think?
I don't see why it'd be necessary. We've gone on for hundreds of years as we are.
But the same could be said of the fish in the lake, but they don't go anywhere and they get eaten. Yes, thank you. We will make our way to the mead hall.
Have a lovely day. And she just kind of weaves off down the street.
You as well.
So you guys head into the town proper and towards the mead hall?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So as you approach this, this building is actually very well kept. The boards are recently stained and lacquered. You know, not like within the last few days, but definitely within the last couple of years, unlike Dugan's Hole, where, you know, they might have done that when they built it. And
Dugan's Hole's not well kept.
It's true. So as you do, I assume you just enter into the meat hall?
Yeah.
Yes.
So as you enter in, you just see a large common area, and immediately as you open the door, just warmth rushes over your body as the heated interior gives you a warm breeze as you enter. And you do see that there is definitely a bar set up along one side that with large casks behind it. And now that you are closer to it, you actually, and I will say that, Hawk, you've been hearing this for a while now. And just now your nature sense kind of kicks in. You hear a buzzing, and as you enter this mead hall, you are very familiar with the fact that it is above you. And it is fairly loud in here.
What kind of buzzing? Like the buzzing of laughter and sunshine?
No, like the buzzing of
a thousand bees.
Yeah, exactly. Many, many bees.
Oh, good.
It's not like that. They need honey, and where would you keep an apiary other than?
Makes sense.
What I'm wondering is where they get the flowers for the bees to create their pollen with. I have questions to the people that run this place.
Of course you do.
All I know is it's loud, and I'm not a fan.
We found something you're finally not a fan of.
I haven't been a fan of most of the things we've encountered.
I could not tell from your face.
That's the point.
So as you enter, you do notice that while there are people in there drinking and such, the mood is very somber.
Are there any other dwarfs in here?
Are there any other what? I'm sorry, say again.
Dwarfs?
Dwarfs? Yes, there are. There are quite a few dwarves, actually. Probably three or four dwarves throughout the area compared to, you know, two or three humans, a couple of elves. So, yes, as Edgar said, a wider gene pool.
Excellent. All right, I'm going to go over and I'm going to get a drink. Either you coming?
I mean, yes, we should.
We should try this mead.
Yeah, and we should see if there's some place in town that Mona might be staying at.
Oh, yeah, that too.
So as you guys head into the town, into the mead hall, and you head up to the bar. The man behind the dwarf behind the counter walks up to you. Hey, oh, you're new here.
Yeah. Like a pint of your best ale.
Oh, I got mead.
All right, a pint of your best mead.
And he takes out a glass and he pours some mead, and it's definitely not a pint, and slides it across the counter.
Thanks.
I'll be 2 silver.
I flip it to him.
Thank you kindly. And a thank for you. And he looks at you, Hawk, and you, Ed.
The same, please. And actually, is there a place in town that we might find lodging?
You can probably ask about in here. We get visitors every now and again, not very often, but I know a couple of people here are more than happy to I have some lodgers in there. And they're either in their houses or in their sheds, depending on who you find.
And do you know if anybody else has come through here in the past day or so?
No, I haven't seen a visitor. Well, not since it happened, at least.
Since what happened?
Oh, you are new here, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, it's sad news, and he takes the cap off his head and holds it up to his chest. Oh, our speaker met a grisly fate just 2 days back. A verbeeg came into town and stole some of the mead that was headed off towards it's been a hard day. But yeah, so our speaker, he tried to defend the mead and stop the verbeeg from walking off with it, but unfortunately he was not so lucky.
All right, what are you saying again?
The verbeeg?
Yes, the verbeeg. Don't you know what a verbeeg is?
Could you spell it for me, please?
Verbeeg. V-E-R-B-E-E-G.
V-E-R-B-E-G.
No, B-E-E-G.
B-E-E-G.
Two E's. Well, three two technically. E's. One in the front and then two in the back.
Have I ever heard of one of these?
I don't know, have you? Let's give you a nature check.
All right.
I will assist.
Sure. Go ahead and take that at advantage.
Given that I know things.
And you drink.
You don't drink. Ooh, not good.
Even with advantage?
Even with advantage.
That's sweet, sweet eight.
You dropped a four, though. It doesn't even really ring a bell.
How do you pull up maps that you have minimized or use the
on the right-hand side, you're going to see all your buttons, and one of those should say maps. And if it doesn't, you're going to click on library at the very bottom, and you're going to make sure that up top next to maps, there's a little check mark.
It does, but it just gives me a bunch of images and maps options.
Yes. So go to the go into the group up top, and you're gonna
uncategorized is where I'm finding it.
Yeah, uncategorized. Yep.
Oh, uncategorized. Okay.
There we go. Thank you.
That's so.
Have I heard of these creatures?
Yes, Varbeegs? You definitely have. Varbeegs. So a verbeeg, and forgive me if I am mispronouncing it. They are. They're in the same family as giants, and they're often found in the company of either ogres or hill giants. They are smart creatures, not like highly smart, but they are definitely smart creatures.
They're not Edgar.
you got an eight.
Okay, fair enough. They're
So yes, they look like, yes.
I'm seeing a void. Oh, there we are.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry, you said people could house us.
Sorry, say again?
People could house us. Could you point someone out in the small gathering that's in this room that might be able to give us a warm place to sleep? I'm terribly sorry to hear about your speaker or your mayor.
Sure. Let me take a look and see who's here at this time. Oh, right over there. Hang on 1 second. Let me just, and he kind of waves over at a an elf nearby, and calls out and is like, "Alkazel, hey, does Is your shed still all patched up and ready to go? And the elf just kind of nods calmly. Oh, I got some adventurers here walking through, and they're looking for a place to cozy up for the night. You still okay with that? And the elf just again just kind of calmly nods.
Thank you. And the drink was 2 silver, you said?
Yes, 2 silver. Yep, that's 2.
I don't have any indication of how much money I have.
Inventory down at the bottom under, or no. Where?
Yep, inventory. Where?
I flipped him 2 more silver.
Noted. Yeah, we'll fix
I'm
that later.
It's under treasure.
Yeah, it's got to be under treasure.
I just have no idea like what I actually own. I'll look that up, but yep. I just know it's -2 silver.
Sure.
I got it.
So as you guys are you gonna hang out in here for a little bit, or you know, explore what you what?
I'm dodging that plot hook as hard as I can.
What plot?
Edgar's not going near a fucking giant. I survived a mammoth and 3 direwolves in my lifetime already, and that is more animals than have tried to kill me in the previous 40-odd years of Edgar's life. I'm not going near anything else.
Okay, but in the immediate future, are you guys hanging out in this tavern or in the main hall?
I'd say we hang around the tavern and see if start we can asking find. Around, see if we can find someone with a raven on their shoulder.
Sure. So as you guys,
or if they heard of someone.
Sure. As you guys sit down, and start asking around, go ahead and roll me an investigation with advantage, because I assume the rest of the party is going to be assisting with this.
Not I, said the hawk.
I'll take it'll be me.
Because your last roll went so well.
Hey, shush.
Oh, that's not bad.
All right, yeah, 16. So you spend a bit of time asking around.
Better me.
But you don't actually. Nobody has seen somebody by Mina or Monist. By Monist description, has come through town at this point yet. However, as you are asking around, you do find out a bit more information. People are very much talking about the unfortunate death of Kendrick Rylesbarrow, which is the speaker of the town. He was a man in his middle ages, and he did unfortunately meet his end to that Verbeeg. And as you guys are asking around, all of a sudden the door to the mead hall opens up, and this dwarf walks in, and he's just got 2 big braids going down the front of his chest, and his hair is slicked back with like oil, which you can see just kind of sticking out a little bit underneath like a nice fur cap, nice and warm. And he walks in, and he's like, "Oi, hello everyone, how are you today? I can," and he just starts walking around, and he's going up to each table like, "Oh, I got your vote, yeah, all right, yeah, there we go." And what do I got? And he's schmoozing like crazy as he walks through the tavern. And he starts. Go ahead.
Is he cute?
He's not ugly. By dwarven standards, yes, I would say he's cute. you know, his nose is a little bit crooked, but he does have very sharp blue eyes, and his hair is just starting to turn gray at the temples.
Too old for me.
I mean, it doesn't take him a day over 250.
I think that's the lifespan of a dwarf.
And he just walks up to to your table after a little bit of time. He's like, "Oh, hello there. Long time since I've seen some new folk in town.
Hello.
What brings you through?"
Adventuring?
Oh, adventuring, eh? Oh, I used to do a fair bit of adventuring in my time. And he kind of elbows you a little bit, Hawk. Oh, yeah. Oh, getting a little on in age to be doing that. No, you know, my knees, they're not what they used to be. Still make a couple of tricks every month or so. Just, you know, keep myself spry. Eh? He does a little bit of shadow boxing over the table.
Yes.
Oh, Mina is so tempted to just punch him back. Like, but she holds back.
So the name is Shandor. Shandor Froth. And, we don't technically have any restrictions on it. So if you're still in town in 3 days' time, I got your vote for a speaker, eh? 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 Another round of mead over here. And he stands up and he walks away.
Can I get a gauge of the room, how they're reacting to him? Sure, like, are they shaking his hand reluctantly of like, yeah, if I shake your hand, you'll go away. Or
give me,
are they like all enthusiastic that this person's here?
I'm going to do an insight on him, not the room.
Sure.
Yeah. Insight?
Yes.
That's a
wisdom check.
It has nothing related to terrain, so cool. Okay.
I mean, you could say you're getting a lay of the land. Figuring out the political land.
He could, but he'd be wrong.
Exactly. Everyone seems to be fine with him. Like, there's definitely a couple people in here that just kind of roll their eyes and are shaking his hands. But some people are just genuinely happy to see him, and they shake his hand just fine. He seems to be like your fairly average political candidate. Some people like him, some people don't. Mina, with that 13 insight, there's something. Like, it's probably just that he's a politician. He just...
They're all smarmy?
Yeah, exactly. That kind of thing.
All right. I'd like to scope out the competition, so. He's not got my vote yet.
Nice.
We're not going to be here in 3 days' time. We have to.
You don't know.
I'm praying we're not here in 3 days' time.
All right, that's fair.
So
I still have a head injury that has not been checked out by a doctor.
It's not going to be.
My arm is still very injured. Hawk's arm is still very injured.
I'm fine. This is the first time this happened.
About literally everything. It's starting to lose its meaning. I'm fairly certain that if you pulled back your bowstring and instead of your arrow it was a snarling saber cat of some sort, you'd go, I'm fine.
Well, in that case, he meant to do it.
Everything is fine until I say I'm not fine. Then there's reason to worry. How about that?
Not good enough.
What were you going to say, Rob?
So, Hawk, with your passive perception, you start to hear from another table nearby just a couple of the humans that are sitting there talking. And there appears to be one woman... so there's a female dwarf sitting with these humans, and she's old, and like her hair is stark white, and her face has wrinkles on it, and her eyes have definitely dulled with age, and she has scars on her face and her arms, and she's just sitting there, and you just hear bits and pieces of the conversation. You hear the word murder at one point. You hear the you hear the name, or you hear the word victim at another point. You hear Bryn Shandar at another point.
Can you spell that lovely name?
Bryn Shandar.
Aha, I guessed it.
Sorry, Shander.
Okay.
I pronounced it the way that I thought it was spelled. Edgar, you are getting advice from chat to suck it up and fight the giant.
I want to know who sent it.
That would be our mod, so she's here to stay.
Yep.
So yeah, is, do you start to try to listen into that conversation a bit more, or?
Yeah, I've already tuned out.
Shocking.
Champion, what's this fuck?
This is my surprise face. So yeah, you do hear this woman is, or this female dwarf. She is just sitting there, and she's just she's talking about this. It appears to be a spree of murders that have been going around the 10 towns recently in the past month. There was a halfling trapper in East Haven, a human shipbuilder in Targos, and then most recently a dwarf glassblower in Bryn Shander.
Okay. And murder victim, Bryn Shander, spree.
As this woman is talking, more and more people start listening in on her conversation, and as is apt to happen in a drunken situation, you've got like one of the elves who has this glass of wine, which confuses you because you know for a fact this place does not serve wine, but still, glass of wine in her hand.
E-Y-O-B.
Just throwing out the craziest of theories. It's like, oh, well, I heard that someone came up from Neverwinter and is assassinating people. And it's like craziness is being thrown around, and none of it seems to make any sense to you. One elderly halfling is convinced beyond reproach that it is an owlbear that is going around and killing these people, to which this elderly dwarf who was telling the story to begin with responds. He's like, and why would an owlbear be using an ice dagger to do their bidding? They have claws, you daft fool.
Have I picked up that Hawk is listening to something?
I assume that you started to ignore Edgar fairly quickly on, so yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I'm not really saying anything, but...
Wow. Good time. I'm just giving it time.
What's this Chuckle's name? Edgar. No, not Edgar. No, the dwarf guy that's schmoozing.
Oh,
the schmoozing dwarf.
Because I assume he said his name at some point.
He did.
Shander Froth?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's...
That's a different name.
Same spelling of Shander?
I write things down phonetically.
Let me confirm. No. That's why I thought it was with an A, because this one's with an A.
Gotcha. Okay. I was going to say, huh, that's an interesting connection there.
Yeah, right.
Okay. If you go into notes, I made this note for Goodmead Public. Just see. A, to see if it works, but...
I can see it. Well, I mean, I can see everything.
Oh, yeah.
But there's a little P next to it saying that it's public, so...
Ooh, I see a Goodmead thing.
Cool.
Okay.
It's public.
So, after about a half hour of this talking, the female dwarf who was telling this story catches your eye, Hawk, and just kind of looks at you knowingly.
The elf?
No. The dwarf. The scarred the one dwarf talking? That was telling the story.
Gotcha. I nod.
So, are you up for a challenge then, lad?
Depends on the challenge.
Well, I've got some money if you're willing to put an end to this killing spree, I'm a bit old myself.
I think I am at least 100 years older than
You're not actually sure about that. This is a very old dwarf.
I mean...
Elves live longer than dwarves, though.
True.
I'm 370, so... Maybe.
If you're interested, well... There's some gold in it for you. This used to be my...
Possibly if you have more information, because...
Oh, I've got plenty. And she just kind of jerks her head to one side, and the elves that were sitting with her just kind of stand up and shuffle off, and she gestures to the stools by her table.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm going to walk away. If Shandar is still there, I'm just going to...
Oh, no, Shandar, he walked away.
You walked away
a while ago.
Yeah, I'm gonna go and sit with
Sure.
I'm fine.
Gonna ask is your name.
So you sit down and my name is Glenn Trollbane. I used to be a bounty
Spelling?
Hunter in this area. Glenn Trollbane.
HLIN.
Correct.
And Trollbane, okay.
HRALLBAIN or BANE?
ANE.
Okay.
It's the I can hear a Scottish accent better than some people can.
So,
been a long time since the train.
I used to be in the bounty hunting business, but I've retired. That doesn't stop me from doing a little investigating, eh? This serial killer, he's got my eye for sure, and I've got my suspicions. But you know, I don't like to be casting accusations without the evidence. But, well, there is one connection that I can see. Well, actually, two connections. First, all three victims reportedly came from towns that sacrificed to Oriel.
Sacrificed to who?
Oh, are you new here?
Sorry, your accent is unfamiliar to me. I thought you said ordeal.
Oriel. You know, the Frost Maiden. The reason we're in this blasted winter.
I'm familiar with the Frost Maiden.
So you know of the sacrifices then, eh?
Can I make a religion check to see if I am?
Sure.
Is religion? That's not what I'm trained in.
Not a clue.
I know what a sacrifice is.
Yeah, you do know what a sacrifice is with a 7. So each of the 10 towns has their own way of sacrificing to the Frost Maiden to avoid her ire, right? So some of them sacrifice the people.
Right. She
draws her hand, her finger across her throat. That really seems to make the Frost Maiden quite happy.
Well, that is a sacrifice.
Some of them sacrifice food. To leave out some of their food, their stocks, for her to take. And some of them sacrifice warmth. They go at night without any heat. That's what they do here in Good Mead, eh? I think it's a wee bit weak of them, if you do ask me. But, you know, they don't ask me often. They take a night without their fires, and they think that the Frost Maiden will take kindly to it. Well, these three victims, they come from the towns that sacrifice the, this way. Second, and this one is where my suspicions really get peaked. All three murders happened while the traveling merchant company Torgs was in town. I know because I make a habit of keeping track where Torga Iceman is. The owner of Torix. Always causing trouble. So I don't know who's doing the murders, but I bet my pa's beard that it's got something to do with those lotteries, the way that they do their sacrifices. They pick who's gonna be sacrificed, eh?
Now, are the sacrifices happening at the same time as the murders? Like on a night where, or in the same time frame as a murder happens,
well,
is
no.
there also a sacrifice of someone else?
No, all the murders have happened in this one month, on different days, whereas only once a month do we do the sacrifices, on the full moon, eh? That should be in about, and she kind of leans back and... I believe it's within the next 10 day. Aye, it should be 3 days from now, actually, we'll see a full moon, eh?
Hmm.
Maybe four.
Well,
no,
maybe...
three, definitely three.
So these three victims were killed outside of a formal sacrifice?
Yes.
Okay.
They were not done on the full moon.
Well, we could always pass on this information to law enforcement in East Haven for you.
Law enforcement? Oh, you're so adorable, Yar.
There is no law enforcement.
Well, that's a shame.
There is.
Well, effective.
There it is.
Well...
All right, so there's been three this month.
Hey. Eh?
And the sacrifices haven't started yet.
Not since the first murder happened, correct.
All right, so was the first murder on the night of a full moon?
That was not, no.
Was it after?
Well, since I said it happened since the last full moon.
All right, I'm sorry, I missed that. How are they kind of equally distant apart in time?
Well, let's see here. The last one happened 3 days ago.
One happened in Bryn Shantae.
Not really. The one before that was a 10 day before it, and the other one was, I believe, just a day before. Maybe it was 2 days before, though. So no pattern in that such.
All right. No, pattern. That's the word I wanted.
What were the name of the towns again? I got Bryn.
So the last victim was in Bryn Shander. The one before that was in Targos. It was a shipbuilder, he was.
Mm-hmm.
And the one before that was in East Haven, just up the road and to the east.
Mm.
Where your friend thinks that the law enforcement is.
So, was your speaker one of the murders?
What? No, we watched them get done. That was done by the Verbeeg who stole the mead.
Oh, right.
No ice dagger there, just a big old spear right in the gut. Three times. Nasty way to go.
Mm.
Well, these are all larger towns.
What towns? I'm sorry. What other towns are the sacrifices killings?
That is a good question. Let me think about that. So I know that Targos, Bryn Shander. Let's see here.
Look, I have a map.
Here we go. Bryn Shander. Those are the three that sacrifice to the people, to the humanoids. Everyone else either sacrifices food or warmth. Oh, that's a clever catch there. That leads me to believe that maybe the next one will take place in one of those three towns again.
So the first one was in East Haven?
The first one was in... the first one was in East Haven, aye.
Strange.
Then we have...
The killer went to Targos and then Bryn... Went through Bryn to Targos and then back to Bryn. So he might be in East Haven again.
Well, I can tell you that according to the schedule that that I keep for Targ's for Targ's traveling caravan, they're actually heading up to Cair Dinnaval next. Wait, no, hang on. She pulls out a list, and you can actually see there is a list of where this place stops. She pulls out this one scroll, you see that she actually has a few scrolls tucked along her belt. The bounty hunter way seems to have been stuck with her. No, my apologies. They're in Cair Dinnaval today. Yes, they'll be back at East Haven in 2 days' time.
The time works out then.
And then they'll be heading down here to Good Mead, in fact.
You say that with a hint of happiness.
Well, I do like to keep my eye on that Torgul, eh?
Fair enough.
What sort of trouble does he normally bring with him?
He's a traveling merchant. You know how they are. Scamming people out of their money, selling watered down healing potions.
So you would be amenable to a more upstanding and reputable shipping company in this area, if there were to be one?
I suppose.
Someone who could reliably bring in quality goods.
I suppose.
Okay. I mean,
we are at the mercies of the wilds up here, eh?
No, it's good to know. It's good to know. And... I have more questions, but not for you.
All right. So here's my deal for you, eh? I will pay you 100 gold pieces.
Each? Yeah.
Total.
All right.
If you apprehend the serial killer and deal with him, eh?
I'm sorry. I think there's a misunderstanding. We're going after I thought we were going
to... Dina puts her hand over Edgar's mouth. And says,
all right,
we'll do it.
All right. When the job is done, you can return to me and collect your money. I'm quite happy here in Greenmead. I think I'll be here for at least a 10-day. Maybe even two.
Do you want us to apprehend only...
I would like you to deal with him as well.
Okay. And would you like it that, if we do apprehend, do you want me to bring them here?
You want us to sacrifice him too?
Proof the deed is done.
There we go.
All that. Could do that.
And I'm going to push Mina's hand away from my mouth. I'm sorry, but... We're not going to be dispensing vigilante justice. If we're apprehending someone, we'll take them to a jury of some kind.
Master Huffling, where did you grow up?
Not around here.
Oh, you're from Boulder. Wait a minute. You're from Boulder's Gate, and you don't believe in vigilante justice? and I'm guessing that you think that Neverwinter is a shining star, too, don't you? Oh, boy. No, you're cute, really.
I look at Edgar and I go, I like her.
You know what? I like him a lot, and I don't want him to feel like the world is out to get him. So you know what? I'm going to up my offer. 150 gold pieces if you do it.
I think that's a fair deal. We're headed there anyway.
In fact, if you take care of it before the next full moon, which is... that's only 2 days off. That's not fair. I'll give you a 10-day. If you take care of it in a 10-day so I don't have to wait here for you, I'll up it to 200.
Well, we're heading up to East Haven anyway.
That's fate, isn't it? Thank the Frost Maiden, hey? Lifts her glass of mead and tosses it back.
In a sense. How far away is East Haven from here?
East roughly? Haven is quite a distance away. It is not as close as the other towns that you have traveled through. So it is 4.5 miles away, which at the rates that you travel here is approximately 12 hours of travel.
Oh, that's not bad.
A long day, but yes.
Yes, a long day.
Oh, we can apparently move stealthy at a normal pace.
Yes.
Oh, only I can. Never mind.
Yes. If you abandon your party, you can do that.
Yeah. But while traveling for an hour or more in the chosen terrain, difficult terrain does not slow your group's travel. Which is lovely. So unless magic happens.
Excellent. Is there anything else you would like to take care of? You've heard a few tales in this tavern. Your host for the evening, Elkhazel, is still within the tavern. If you would like to make sure you know where you're going for the night.
Yeah, we should meet up with Elkhazel.
Yes.
So you walk over to Elkhazel's table and the dwarf Hlin. Just raises her glass to you one more time. Takes another sip. In fact, you do notice it's a fairly large mug that she's drinking out of, and she's never once refilled it all night, but she just keeps drinking out of it.
It's magic.
She's crazy. We might not be the first people she's offered 200 gold pieces for to go chase down murderers that don't exist. Secondly, when did we become a mercenary party? I hired you to get me to East Haven.
You hired a mercenary to take you to East Haven, yes.
You didn't tell me you were a mercenary. You told me you were a woodsman and
yes.
Someone who knew...
Not a lie.
Forget it.
Mercenary is another title. Just like adventurer.
Update your business card. Update your business card, please.
And on that note, you meet up with Elkhazel. She graciously brings you off to her abode, which is on the northern edge of town. It is this large house right here. And actually brings you out back to a small barn that as you enter, it is actually, it does have a wood stove in it that is already going for you, and the place is nice and cozy warm, and there are some fluffed bedrolls on the floor ready for you. It seems like this is not an uncommon occurrence here in Goodmead. And that is we are going to wrap it up for the evening with you nestling down for the night in a far more hospitable town than Dugan's Hole. As you wonder where your wayward companion is and ponder whether your future holds giants or serial killers or the most fearful of them all, fearsome of them all, excuse me, an election.
Very true.
Thank you all so by much for joining stressful. Us tonight. Just a reminder, you can find us over on Facebook, where you can like us to follow along. We're going to do our best to keep updating that. I do plan to have several contests as we move forward. Each week, I will be giving away a different miniature. Here on this channel, I am actually going to be hosting more painting of miniatures, and I'm going to get in the habit of every Wednesday afternoon before we live stream Cold Case Files. That afternoon, I will actually paint whatever miniature it is that we will be giving away that evening during our break. So thank you once again for joining us. If you want to catch up on this, you can always catch episode 1 and 2 now up on my YouTube channel. And sometime in the next week, week and a half, this will be coming out on podcast form as well.
Ooh, sweet.
Because I work professionally in theater, and I have nothing else to do with my time right now. Thank you all so very much for joining us. This is where I would insert a witty catchphrase, but I don't have one. So have a lovely night, all. Stay safe, stay healthy.
Good night, everybody. Update your business cards.
Ha ha ha.